What is health? Is health a right or is health a commodity? Let's imagine that you believe health is a right and you eventually study the distribution of health and disease and you see how terribly conditioned it is by inequalities. So you think you need a new definition of health. You need a definition of sustainable health. And you think that this definition should be encompassing all kinds of humans, but not only humans, also environment, and not only your generation, but also future generations. So you are in a bit of trouble because you see that actually your idea, your concept is very nice, but has a big problem that is at odds with the system of capitalism and growing and growing and growing and producing and producing and producing and but all of a sudden, you see a historian coming through that door and taps into your shoulder and tells you, I'm going to bring you to a different scenario. Okay, wait a minute. What does that mean? History can make us travel to different times and different places. Places where the moral and political values that we have nowadays don't exist. For example, we can travel to 18th century Peru, before the liberal era in the 18th century, to this municipality, the town of Loja, where citizens of this village had a very close relationship with the Chinchona bark that is named Asquina as well, and that was a remedy to cure fevers. Back in the 18th century, and therefore they established a much closer relationship with their environment and also a much more strong feeling of identity and community. Therefore, what I propose is that epidemiologists, people who care about how health is nowadays, should be open to collaborate with the history of medicine, and together we can actually look back to look forward. Thank you.